So, you have one last week to submit your video. It seems like some of you enjoy living life on the edge, which is fine because it's still possible to get started and complete your video if you procrastinate a lot less. First and most importantly, I would like to direct you to the Breakthrough FAQ website. It has everything you need to know, from the requirements to judging criteria to peer-to-peer, it's all there. Okay, now on to the deets. Where did I get my music from? In Incompetech.com. If you're looking for sound effects, I use those that are built into iMovie. But you can also Google for royalty-free ones or find those contributed by users on YouTube. What did I use for filming slash editing? iPhone for shooting, iMovie for editing. That's it. Stop motion is essentially taking a bunch of photos and putting them together like a really fast slideshow. If you are short on time, whiteboard drawings work great as well. You just record yourself drawing stuff, then you speed it up. How about software animation? The animations I have are from YouTube. I basically refer to their fair use policy, which I will link in the description below. If you're looking for ready-made animations that you can place and move around specifically, Powtoon and VideoScribe are pretty good websites for those. I think Hillary, who is last year's winner, is a much better person to ask for animation advice because she makes her own and they are gorgeous. If you are a noob, and you're looking for a super easy way to animate your stuff, I figured out a really dumb way to get it done on Google Slides, like last month. So stick around for the tutorial at the end of this video and I'll show you how. It's kind of time consuming like stop motion, but really great, really easy if you're just looking for a quick way to move your stuff around ASAP. Okay, next question. I'm still lost about my topic. Okay, pal, you're cutting it a bit close, but okay. There are three big categories: physics, life sciences, and math. If you have a favorite, pick one. If you are all rounded, I am jealous but proud of you. List your favorite topics under each category. They should be topics that are pretty much established in the scientific community. Out of all these topics you have, which do you like most? Here are two more questions to help you narrow down your options. Can you imagine explaining this topic to a friend for 3 minutes straight? And can you make it an interesting story? For inspiration, you could watch YouTube videos of how other people explain your topic and see what they focus on. What do people want to know? What do people find interesting? Learning by example is a great way to find all of that out. Also, read up about your topic. Know it like the back of your hand. Think about how it relates or forms parallels to your life. For example, I like games. Evolution is kind of like a game, a Hunger Games, but on slow-mo. Follow-up question, is my topic difficult enough? I think it's difficult enough if it's a college slash high school level sort of topic. If you learn it in high school, explain something about it that you find interesting that most people may not know. Personally, the best approach is to show people something they haven't thought of before. It could be your concept itself or the way you choose to present it. Like, have you ever thought of superbugs as Ninja Turtles? Same. And I thought people would want to see that, so whoop, that went into my video. Next question, how do I shorten my script? Truly the struggle for every aspiring filmmaker. You have a beautiful script with details, jokes, language that would make Neil deGrasse Tyson cry with pride. The problem is you are 5 minutes overboard. I get it. That script is your baby. It physically hurts to cut it. You have no idea how many puns I sacrificed in my video. Shortening a script makes you stronger as a person. What you can do is think of your video as an introduction to your topic as opposed to a full-blown mega explainer that could possibly be half an hour long or more. Your purpose is to get someone interested in your topic, to learn something new from it, and be inspired to find out more about it on their own. Sometimes all you have to do is untangle a specific knot in your topic. I was confused about DNA replication until I saw an animation of the replication bubble, you know, the leading and lagging strand, and I was like, oh! As a student, did you struggle with your topic? How did you overcome that? Do whatever works best for your topic based on your own experience learning it. Last but not least, where is the tutorial? This is a tutorial of how I made this entire explainer video. A video in a video, videoception. Okay, I'll shut up now.
So what I do first is I take a picture of the screen, of the frame in which the animations are going to appear. It doesn't have to be exact, you just need to know the rough positions of your animation. Okay. Now, to make them transparent on iMovie, you have to change the background to a green screen color. Okay, now we throw in our pictures. This is the Incompetech one. Okay, now you just have to add a text box with what you want to say and animate it. So I'm gonna make this one fly in from the right. And I usually keep the speed at 0.3 seconds because that's fast, but not too fast. And once you've used your background picture as a frame of reference, you can just get rid of it. And this is absolutely dumb. What you do is you click present, and then you just press enter. You should hold for about 5 seconds for each animation, so it gives you some room to edit once you go to iMovie. Once you've transferred your video to the media library in iMovie, you can start adding them on top of your current clips. So here's Incompetech, we're gonna delete that and put the animation in. It takes a bit of snipping sometimes to get it right. So you can just delete the clips that aren't useful. So here's where I say Incompetech. So now you notice there's a green screen that cuts away. So you click this button and click green screen. Voila, it appears.
So that is how I make my animations, which is honestly really new. If you have a more efficient way of doing it, please let me know. But if you don't, I hope this helps you, and see you again soon.